We're making cannoli. There's 6 fried tubes of sweet pastry filled with ricotta cheese that comes from southern Sicily. And to begin, you make a dough consisting of flour, a little bit of cocoa, a little bit of granulated sugar and salt. And we're going to do this in a food processor because it goes by very, very quickly. Process these dry ingredients for, oh, maybe 5 seconds or so. And then add 2 tablespoons of vegetable shortening. And if you prefer, you could certainly use lard, which would be more traditional. And then process for about 10 seconds until the shortening is cut into really small pieces. It's a fine crumb mixture. And then start pouring through the feed tube 6 tablespoons of sweet Marsala wine. You could also use sweet vermouth. And the idea is that you want to form a dough. It's going to be like a pasta dough. Let's just gather into a ball and then process for 1 full minute. Okay, let's see what we have. Oh, this is very, very nice. And it smells of cocoa. And it smells like that wonderful sweet Marsala. Now, at this point, you're going to want to put it onto your counter and knead it for about 2 to 3 minutes. But you don't want it to be any firmer than this. And then also, as you knead it, you might notice that the dough breaks. You see what's happening to it here? It's just kind of breaking and tearing. And that's perfectly okay. This is expected to happen. So after 2 to 3 minutes of this, you'll want to take the dough and wrap it up and let it rest for at least an hour. Notice that it even darkens over time. And then during this hour, this dough becomes very supple. And we'll want to cut it into quarters. And we'll work with 1 quarter at a time. So you can keep those covered. And to work this dough, you'll need a pasta machine that you set at the widest setting, and then just flatten the dough and pass it through the machine, just like that. And then the dough will flatten a little bit, and then fold it in thirds. And then put it through at right angles to your first put through. And then you'll see that it becomes almost rectangular. Fold it in thirds. And then turn it to the open edge of the fold, go through. And then repeat this maybe 3 or 4 times. And then proceed to decrease the setting on your pasta machine. And then you're going to be putting your dough through your pasta machine at each decreasing setting just once. And if the dough feels at all sticky, at any point, you're going to want to flour it because you don't want it sticking to itself. This is feeling just the slightest bit damp. But rather than take any chances, I'm going to just dust it lightly with flour, and then move on to the next setting. This is number 6. And since there are 7 settings on this pasta machine, this is where I'm going to stop. I don't want to go beyond the next to last setting. And this particular setting is going to get the dough very, very thin. Look at that. Look how it extended. So that's 1 piece. Now you have 3 more pieces, so you want to repeat this whole procedure with those 3 pieces. And then you can have this template. This is a 4.5-inch oval. And you just lay this oval directly onto your dough. And then just carve out. That oval. There. This is a lovely little template, and then you'll need like these cannoli cubes. You can buy these, they're stainless steel, they come in sets of four, and there's no special treatment for the tubes. You just take the dough and arrange it lengthwise on the tube, and you'll see here how the ends just barely overlap. So take an egg white, dip your finger into the egg white, rub egg white along the exposed egg, and then just when the seams meet, just pinch them together very gently. And then you're going to want to set this down on a tray lined with plastic wrap. And if you only have four cannoli tubes, then you'll just make four of these. And if you have more, then just keep rolling and cutting and making cannoli like this for as many tubes as you have. And then once the cannoli are at this stage, we're ready to fry them. When the oil is heated to about 360 degrees, drop two or three cannoli tubes into the oil, and in just a few seconds, they'll rise to the surface. And they turn this pinkish color from the cocoa. One of these is getting done faster than the other one. You pick it up and see if you can shake it off the tube, and if you can't, just pull it off with some paper towels and then let the tube of pastry fall back into the oil. And then let me do the same thing with this. It should come right off very easily. There we go. And then we will keep cooking for a total of about 2 to 2.5 minutes until they're just very crisp and bubbly and a deep brown color. And when the cannoli tubes are completely cool, you can store them for a couple of days in a covered container at room temperature, and then fill them just before you want to serve them.